I think it's important to be aware that globalization is not there to stay necessarily. Just 1 or 2 years ago, most people would believe that globalization was irreversible and triumphant. A minority of people would say not necessarily, because there might be a social political backlash due to inequalities across countries and within countries brought about by globalization. Now, what we have seen is something different, that is a serious crack on globalization, but not due to inequalities, rather due to the technical implosion of the financial system. Does this mean that the risk of having in the future problems to the global economy due to inequalities is out of the scene? Not at all. I think that is a problem that has to be tackled head on. The risk I see now is that all the minds and all the international cooperation are focusing on how to remedy to the financial crisis, which is good enough, should have been done earlier, but let us not neglect to put in place some system of global governance that would allow for a serious fight against international and domestic inequalities. Certainly not one leader, but a number of leading countries. I think there is now a nice combination transatlantically, because we have the US, which of course bears a huge portion of the responsibility of the crisis, but led by a new figure who is able to project hope. Let's hope this goes on. So leadership is clearly coming from the US, but from the European Union as well, particularly because the European Union, if we reflect for a moment, is the only place in the world where a real governance of globalization, albeit limited to the continental scale, has functioned successfully for 50 years. So Europe has in its DNA the know-how for governing globalization. So that is the US, the EU, and of course now there is all of a sudden, these two should have come earlier, the realization that you can do nothing without China, India, Brazil, etc., and some representative countries also of the less flamboyant emerging countries. So this is the sort of collective leadership that I believe is emerging. To take the lead alone, no. To be the biggest provider of expertise and culture of governance, and to work with others, yes. And there, it's really a pity that the Lisbon Treaty is not yet in force, because that would have made things easier for Europe, because we would have already a semi-permanent president of the EU, etc., etc. But nevertheless, this is a good moment for the EU to project its soft power across the world, a soft power which is a culture, a governance, and which is actually in high demand. I'm glad you raised this, because I think it's increasingly crucial. This inclusiveness has to be several things. First of all, I think it has to mean trying to promote a well-informed debate on globalization. And I believe what the Bertelsmann Foundation is doing generally, and at this conference in particular, is of great help in that respect. But we also need, as you say, to have civil society and its organizations to take a leading role, different from that of governments. And here, again, the European Union has something to say, because, after all, it is the only international organization which has a democratic structure, in the sense that one key institution of European integration is a parliament, the European Parliament, which is universally elected by citizens. So I think this is a model which it will not be possible to reach quickly at the global level, but points in a direction. And to achieve that, the involvement of the civil society, as you say, will be crucial.